Hey everyone, in this tutorial I'm going to talk about getting started with the Motion Live 2D plugin for Cartoon Animator 4, which allows you to transfer 3D motion capture data to your 2D characters in a 2D environment. There's an array of mocap gear that you can use with Cartoon Animator 4, and I'll show you how simple it is to animate your own drawings, characters, and digital puppets in no time. Let's start by connecting the face profile first. You can find the Motion Live 2D plugin in the plugins menu at the top. In the plugin panel, you'll find a gear list and a character list. The gear list is essentially a list of gear profiles that you have installed. Here you can see that we have the Face 3D profile, which is included with the Motion Live plugin, and also the iPhone profile. For the iPhone profile, you need to make sure that your iPhone device has a true depth camera, which is found on iPhone 10 and newer versions. Once we select our character, it will appear in the character list. If we want to capture with the Face 3D profile, we'll need to open up the standalone Face 3D tracker first. Once we open that, you'll be able to see yourself, or in this case, our mysterious guest mocap actor. Next, you'll want to click on the hollow red circle beside the Face 3D profile in order to activate it. Once it's activated, it will turn green, which ensures that the data can now be received from the Face 3D tracker and sent to the Motion Live 2D plugin. What we want to do next is select the gear profile that we want our selected character to use. In this case, we're going to animate the face, so we'll select the Face 3D profile under the face column. Let's go ahead and give it a quick preview by clicking Preview and then hitting the spacebar. The results may be slightly off at first, so what you need to do is set a neutral zero pose by clicking on the button when you have a neutral expression. Make sure that your face is directly angled towards the camera and you're not smiling or frowning, almost like taking a passport photo. What that does is it gives the Motion Live plugin a reference point for where your facial features are so it can provide a more accurate capture. Next, we can add a bit of body capture as well by activating the Face 3D for body profile and selecting it from the body column in the character list. Once we preview this, you can see that the body itself is now moving according to the movements of the head. You'll see the upper body stretch and move according to the head movements, which adds a bit more realism. Once you're happy with your preview setup, you can go ahead and start recording. It's the same process, except this time you'll want to hit the record button instead of preview. Hit the space bar to start the recording, and then again once you're finished. You'll see the timeline has moved ahead, and you can play back to see the results of your raw capture. To find out where the data was recorded, you'll want to open your timeline and show the motion and face tracks. In each track, you'll see puppet clips that were recorded. You can move, manipulate, and edit these clips in various ways, but we'll talk about that in more detail in editing tutorials. For now, let's close down the timeline and check out the panel display settings before we move on to connecting the body and hand profiles. Here, the settings are quite simple. You can adjust the panel opacity so you can see more of the capture area, or you can decide to hide the panel altogether when you start previewing or recording. You can see an example of this as I begin the preview. Okay, let's move on to connecting the body profile. Here you can see a preview of Axis Neuron Pro on the right, and we're going to open the Motion Live panel once again, only this time we're going to connect to the body profile. You can also access the plugin from the add-on toolbar at the top as well. This time you can see there are more body profiles available, and we're going to use the Perception Neuron one. The first thing to note is the IP address beside the profile. You want to make sure this is identical to the one in Axis Neuron Pro. To check this, go to the settings under the file menu and check the IP and port numbers under General. You'll also want to make sure under Broadcasting that TCP is selected and that BVH output is enabled on the same port address. Once you've got all that settled, the next item of business is to activate the Neuron profile in the Motion Live plugin. If you're using Perception Neuron Studio gloves, you can also activate those in the hand section below body. Next, go ahead and select the Perception Neuron devices from the respective body and hand columns. The last thing to do is define your hand settings like so, as the default setting is used for Leap Motion hand capture. Once that's all done, we can preview just like we did before with the face capture. And just like with the face capture, you'll want to give the plugin a reference point to get the most accurate body capture. For body, this means getting into a T pose, which is exactly like you see here. Once that's set, you'll need to click on the Set T Pose button and then go ahead and preview for more accurate capture. Okay, lastly, let's take a look at connecting the Leap Motion gear profile for the hands. Before we do anything in Cartoon Animator, we need to make sure that we have the correct settings in the Leap Motion control panel first. First, you'll want to make sure that you have Allow Web App selected. This will be deselected by default each time you open the control panel, so you want to make sure that you enable it each time. Next, head over to the Troubleshooting tab. If all of your device status indicators are green, then you're good to go. You'll also want to enable low resource mode in order to get the best capture quality. Make sure to press the Apply button to save those settings before you move on. Next, you'll want to load up the diagnostic visualizer to ensure that the capture device is working properly. Once you're done with that, let's get to previewing. Just like with the other devices, you'll want to click the empty red circle beside the profile and also select from the hand columns in the character list. You can then preview and see your results. To get the most accurate hand capture, we also want to set a zero pose for the hands. To get that ready, select the button on the right and then follow the instructions. You'll be asked to put your hands into these two poses for a few seconds to calibrate properly. The first pose is hands open and straight. Don't open them too wide for the best result. When making the fist, relax them a little and don't clench them too hard. When you're done, you can then preview and see the results and see that the character's fingers will now be straight when the palms open. There are four different modes with Leap Motion hand capture: hands, fingers, forearm IK, and upper arm IK. In hand mode, you'll see that the finger and wrist motions will be captured. You can also flip your hands, but if you don't want this, ensure that you deselect the auto hand flip checkbox. In finger mode, only the fingers will move. However, hand flipping will not be ignored. Next, let's try forearm IK. In this mode, motions from the elbows to the fingers will be captured. You can see that the forearm bones will be scaled down in order to simulate the scale effect. Finally, let's try upper arm IK. As you can probably guess, this method will move the entire arm and utilize human IK on your character's bone structure. We have a lot of other tutorials that go into more detail on specific capture techniques and editing, but for now, that's really all I want to show you in this introductory tutorial. Cartoon Animator is a pioneer in 2D motion capture, and the ability to drive 2D animated characters with hand, body, and face mocap simultaneously is a stellar development.